Hello and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will create a CI/CD pipeline by using Microsoft Azure DevOps. So the first step is to sign in the Azure DevOps portal and then create an organization. Let's click on continue. Insert the organization name. Entering the captcha. And then clicking on continue. Okay, now we have to create a project. So let's give a project name. That's RH thesis drift. Okay, and then create project. So the first thing is to push the code from our local machine to the Azure repos. So in my case, I have a simple Java application. I will push it to Azure repos. I open the terminal. Now I have to navigate to the directory where the source file is located. Those are the files that I have to commit. So the first command is to init the project, the command git init. Now the command git remote add origin plus the link of the Azure repos. We can get it from here and copy the link and paste it in the command line. Okay, let's check the status, git status. Okay, now we add the files with git add dot. Okay, now we can make our first commit, git commit dash m first commit. Okay, and now I can push the code with the command git push origin master. I have to insert the password of the Azure repos. I can get it from here. Copy the password, paste it here, and the file has been pushed to the Azure repos. Okay, let's reload now, and here we can see that the file has been pushed. We can find here the Dockerfile and the source code file. Okay, let's go back now to the Azure portal. We have to create a Kubernetes cluster. Let's search in the bar Kubernetes. Let's click on add Kubernetes cluster. Okay, the first thing we need is to create a resource group. Let's create one. Create new. So dash Rodriguez thesis dash SLH. Okay, let's enter the Kubernetes cluster name, aks-srh-thesis. For the region, I will choose Germany West Central. For the size, I will choose 4 CPU or 2 CPUs and 4 GB RAM. That's enough for my application. And I will just select two nodes, choose two nodes, and then let's go to integration. Here we can create a container registry. We need one to push our Docker image. Okay, let's click on create new container registry. Create new. We enter a registry name. Answer edge dash traces dash drift dash, or we don't have to enter dash, can keep it like this. I will select the resource group that I created, the region, and I will disable the admin user. For the SKU is for pricing, I will choose just the standard one. Okay, let's click on OK. We keep the container monitoring enabled, and we can just click on review plus create. Okay, now the validation is passed. We can create the Kubernetes cluster and the Azure container registry. The deployment is in progress. This will take a few minutes until 5 minutes, and it will create the Azure container registry and the Azure Kubernetes cluster. Now the resources has been created. We can create the CI/CD pipeline. So now let's go to the Azure DevOps portal. We can create pipeline by going to pipeline, create pipeline, but it will take a long time, but the easy way is to go to the Azure Kubernetes service that we created. And here we go to Deployment Center. And here we will say, okay, choose the source file from the Azure repos that we committed before. We can also use GitHub or the Bitbucket. Let's click on Next. Next is the organization, which is the project that we created, the repository, and next. And here the deployment center will detect the Dockerfile. I push it to the Azure repos, and it will say, okay, this is your Dockerfile. And I also inserted the port number, which is in my case 8080. Let's click on next. Here I have to specify the namespace for the AKS cluster. I will leave it AKS stasis or 2020-2021. And the container registry that it created before, and let's click on done. Okay, the AKS deployment center will create the CI/CD pipeline, and this process will take a few minutes. Okay, now we can see that the CD has been completed. We can see the pipeline here. And on the Azure DevOps, we can click on the pipeline. And you can see that this is the first commit and this is the pipeline just running. We can also see the task of the pipeline by a click on the pipeline, but in our case, the pipeline will fail because the pipeline will not build the WAR file for the Java application. So for that, yeah, the pipeline has been failed. So we have to edit the pipeline. And we have to add a new job. Add new task, let's search for Maven, and let's add Maven for building the WAR file. We don't need the GUnit test results. Let's deselect the publish to Azure pipeline, and let's click on save and queue. Let's enter a new change and save and run. Okay, the pipeline starts again. We can see the steps. It will take some time or building the war file with Maven than building the Docker file with the Docker file that we pushed, and then it will push the Docker image to the Azure Container Registry. Okay, now we can see that the CI pipeline has been done. We can see the CD in the release here on the release pipeline. Let's click on AKS SMH thesis. Okay, this is the CD pipeline. We can click on it. And the CD pipeline is still in progress. We can click here to see the logs. Okay, it will pull the image from the Azure Container Registry and will generate the YAML file, and it will push the image to the Kubernetes cluster with the YAML file. This CI/CD pipeline will generate automatically the YAML file, so the user don't need to generate a YAML file. It will take some minutes. Okay, now we can see that the CD pipeline has been done. We can test our application on the localhost of the EKS. Let's go to services. Okay, this is the service that the Kubernetes created now. This is the external IP address with the port 8080. Let's click on the external IP address and add the port 8080. Okay, this is the application we created in Eclipse. Okay, we can understand the CI/CD pipeline working well, but in case, for example, let's suppose that the developer wants to make changes in the application. I have a small change here. I can copy the change in the Eclipse, or I can also insert it directly in the Azure Repos. Okay, now I can commit. In case the user commits a new change, the pipeline will start again. We can check here in the pipeline, updated home.jsp. We can see that the pipeline just started right now. It will take again some minutes to build the war file and build the Docker image and push this Docker image to the Azure Container Registry. Okay, now we can also see the CD pipeline. The new CD has been created. It will push the Azure container image that we created to the Kubernetes cluster. Let's have a look, see on the logs. Pulling the image, generating the manifest file, deploying the image to the Kubernetes cluster with the YAML file. All steps are automated. Okay, that's good. Now let's refresh. Okay, the change has been done. Does it mean that the CI/CD pipeline is automated and whenever the code has been changed, it will be changed here. Okay, let's have a manual test by inserting the curl command on the Azure portal bash. Let's enter the command curl and the IP address of the cluster 10.0.22. No, the I need to enter the external IP address. 20, 79, 65.5, and the port is 8080. Okay, it will say that the server is running well, the website is well. Okay, this is a manual test for the for this website. We can also do automated tests with, for example, Selenium, which is our third party tool, but that means that the website is running well on the Kubernetes cluster. Okay, this is the end of this tutorial. I have you understand the CI/CD pipeline in Azure, and thank you for watching this video.